For straight lines, we need some basic concepts what we have learned in our lower classes, like distance formula, section formula, midpoint. Those things let us remember. First of all, distance formula. So what is the distance formula? Suppose we have two points A and B in a plane, then what is the distance between the two points A and B is what? What is the distance formula? Suppose here we have the point A, it is the point B. The distance between that two points, the point A is x1, y1, the point B is x2, y2. So these are the two points in a plane. How to find its distance? How to find its distance? For to find the distance, we have one formula. That is what? The distance between two points AB equals to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Or this also can be written as AB equals to square root of x2 minus x1 is also can be written as x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square. So it is what? The distance between the points A and B. So make a note in your notebook. If A, x1, y1 and B, x2, y2 are two points in a plane, then the distance between A and B is AB equals to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Or it can also be written as x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square, right? So it is what? The distance formula. Suppose we have origin. Suppose we have the point P. The distance from the point P to the origin. Suppose you just see we have origin. It is what? Origin. It is what? Origin. Okay. Here we have the point P. That point will be x, y or x1, y1, whatever it may be. The distance between the point P and its origin is what? What is the distance between origin and the point P is what? How to find its distance? OP equals to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. So x minus 0 whole square is x square plus y minus 0 whole square is y square. So x square plus y square. It will be the distance between the origin and the point P. So take a note that the distance between the origin and the point P and the point P x comma y is OP equals to square root of x square plus y square. So it is the distance between the origin and the point P. If you want to take a screenshot, you can take or pause the video. You just take a note. I mean, you just write on in your notebook. After this, I just scroll down the sheet. I mean, this sheet, I just scroll down. Later, I can't scroll it back. So here itself, you just note down. Now, let us know section formula. Section formula. In section formula, we have cases. That's what? Internal case and external case. Suppose if we have internal case. So let us know the section formula for internal case. A point P divides the line segment AB in the ratio m is to n internally is the coordinates of the point P which divides the line joining A and B in the ratio m is to n is the coordinates of the point P which divides A x1 y1 and B x2 y2 in the ratio m is to n is it is what internal case is m x2 plus n x1 divided by m plus n next m y2 plus n y1 divided by m plus n it is what internal case what about external case see external case the coordinates of a point P which divides the line segment AB in the ratio m is to n in the ratio m is to n externally m is to n externally see in this internal case we have this point in between A and B that means what that point P divides internally in this external case that point P is outside of AB this point P is the outside of AB it is what external case the coordinates of a point P which divides the line segment A x1 y1 and B x2 y2 in the ratio m is to n is mx2 minus n x1 p equals to m x2 minus n x1 divided by m minus n m y2 minus n y1 divided by m minus n it is what external case it is internal case and it is external case now if you want to take a screenshot you can take otherwise you can pause the video then you may note down So these are the basic formulas Now midpoint So how to find the midpoint of the line segment joining two points Suppose we have a line joining points A x1 y1 and the point B x2 y2 okay It is a line segment joining A x1 y1 and B x2 y2 what about the midpoint of C how to find the midpoint x1 plus x2 by 2 y1 plus y2 by 2 isn't it so therefore the coordinates of the midpoint of the line segment joining A x1 y1 and B x2 y2 is C equals to how to find the midpoint of A and B x1 plus x2 by 2 y1 plus y2 by 2 so it is what midpoint I understand now if you want to take a screenshot you can take otherwise pause the video now let us know about the triangles types of triangles So triangles already we have learned in our lower classes, types of triangles. So first one is equilateral triangle. Yes, what is mean by equilateral triangle? What is a equilateral triangle? Already you have learned in your lower classes that equilateral triangle, isosceles, scalen, right angle triangle. So all these things already you have learned. Now you just remember, you just recall what is mean by equilateral triangle. If the length of three sides of a triangle are equal, the length of three sides, suppose we have one triangle, equilateral triangle, the length of three sides of a triangle are equal, then it is called an equilateral triangle. So angle is also same. Therefore AB equals to AB equals to AC equals to BC, or BC equals to CA. So all the sides are equal, and also angles are also equal. Angle A, angle B, and angle C. So what is mean by equilateral triangle? If the length of three sides, if the length of three sides of a triangle are equal, then it is called an equilateral triangle. Therefore the sides AB equals to BC equals to CA, and angles is also equal, angle A, angle B, and angle C. So it is equilateral triangle. Now let us move on to the isosceles triangle. What is mean by isosceles triangle? Yes, define a isosceles triangle. So isosceles triangle is nothing but, if the length of any two sides of a triangle, suppose we have A, the length of any two sides of a triangle are equal, then it is called an isosceles triangle. You just write the definition of a isosceles triangle, that if the length of any two sides, of a triangle are equal, then it is called an isosceles triangle. Condition is what? Here AB equals to AC in this triangle, but not equals to BC. So condition will be AB equals to BC, or BC equals to CA, or CA equals to AB. It is the isosceles triangle. Okay. Now scalen triangle. Scalen triangle. As define a scalen triangle. What is mean by a scalen triangle? If the length of any two sides are not equal, suppose here we have A, if the length of any two sides like this, maybe this triangle looks like isosceles triangle.
I'm just
scale and triangle is if the length of any two sides are not equal. Suppose here we have A, any two sides are not equal, like this, any two sides are not equal, then it is called a scale and triangle. A, B, C, like this. You have to imagine. I can't draw a perfect diagram in the sheet. I can draw scale and triangle in a graph sheet. Then only that triangle will be perfect. You just imagine. What is meant by scale and triangle? If the length of any two sides are not equal, then it is called scale and triangle. The definition of a scale and triangle. Okay, now we will move on to the right angled triangle. Right angled triangle. So what is mean by a right angle triangle? Right angle triangle. If a triangle satisfies Pythagoras' formula, then we can say that triangle is a right angle triangle. That's it. Very simple. If a triangle satisfies, it is the definition of a right angle triangle. If a triangle satisfies Pythagoras formula, then it is called a right angle triangle. Now we will move on to the one more type, that right angled isosceles triangle. Right angled isosceles triangle. So what is mean by a right angled isosceles triangle? Of a right angle triangle, right angle isosceles triangle. If a triangle satisfies Pythagoras formula and if a triangle satisfies Pythagoras formula and any two sides are equal, then it is called right angled isosceles triangle. So these are the types of a triangles. Now if you want to take a screenshot, you can take, otherwise you can pause the video. First, now you just may write down in your notebook. Kindly do not make any kind of mistakes in your notebook. So these are the types of triangles we have just discussed in this class. Now, how to find an area of a triangle? So what is the formula to find the area of a triangle? If A x1 y1, B x2 y2, and C x3 y3 are the vertices of a triangle, then its area is given by. So what is the formula for to find the area of a triangle? Area, it is denoted by delta 1 by 2 into modulus of x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. So it is the formula to find the area of a triangle. Now we will learn types of quadrilaterals. In this, let us know about square. Yes, what is meant by a square? if the length of all the sides are equal. What is meant by a square? If the length of all the sides are equal. A, B, C, D. If the length of all the sides are equal, then and its diagonals is also equal. These are the diagonals. The length of all the sides are equal and the diagonals are also equal. Then that equilateral is called a square. It is the definition of a square. So what is the condition? AB, AC equals to AB equals to BD equals to CD. AB equals to BD equals to CD equals to AC. It is the first one. Second thing will be diagonals. CB and AD are equal. So BC equals to AD. If these conditions are satisfied, then we can say that quadrilateral will be a square. Now we will move on to the rectangle. Yes, what is a rectangle? Define a rectangle. If the length of opposite sides are equal and diagonals are also equal, then that quadrilateral is called a rectangle. A, B, C, D. So what are the two things? What are the conditions? If the length of opposite sides, AB equals to CD, and AC equals to BD, if the length of opposite sides are equal and diagonals are also equal, AD equals to BC, then it is called a quadrilateral. These are the two types of a quadrilateral. We will have many more types of a quadrilateral like rhombus, trapezium, parallelogram. So all these things we have, and also we have learned about quadrilaterals in our lower classes. I don't have so much time to explain all those things. So whatever is required for straight lines, those things only explained. Now let us move on to the centroid of a triangle. Is what is the formula to find a centroid of a triangle? Suppose we will have a triangle A, B, C. So how to find the centroid of a triangle? This will be the centroid of a triangle. Centroid of a triangle is denoted by capital G. So what is the formula to find a centroid of a triangle? If A एक्स वन वाई वन बी एक्स टू वाई टू एंड सी एक्स थ्री वाई थ्री आर द वर्टिसेस ऑफ ए ट्राइंगल ए बी सी देन इट्स सेंट्रॉयड विल बी एक्स वन प्लस एक्स टू प्लस एक्स थ्री बाई थ्री वाई वन प्लस वाई टू प्लस वाई थ्री बाई थ्री. It is the formula to find a centroid of a triangle. Are you understand? So based on this concept, let us solve one or two questions related to this basic. Note down the problems. Find the distance between the following points. We will have sub questions. First one, 2, 3 and 3, 2. We have to find the distance between these two points. How to find its distance? We already know that the distance between two points will be square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square, right? Distance d equals to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square 3 minus 2 3 minus 2 whole square plus 2 minus 3 2 minus 3 whole square. That is equals to square root of 3 minus 2 is 1 square plus 2 minus 3 is minus 1 whole square. That is equals to square root of 1 square is 1 plus minus 1 whole square is 1 equals to root 2. Next sub question B. B question will be homework for you 3 comma minus 4 and minus 4 comma 7. Next one, origin 0, 0 and 3, 4. So these are the questions B and C. These are the questions homework for you. Okay, dear students, it is the class for today. In the next class, we will continue. In this class, what we have discussed, all these are basic. What we have learned in our previous, lower classes. Okay, in the next class, we will continue with the concept of straight lines. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you.